So, good evening and welcome to Fleece TV. And we've got a lovely show for you tonight. We've got our home correspondent Robert from Toronto with one of his pieces of poetry. We've got Phoebe singing a song towards the end and an exploration of the stone circles. But we're going to start with that poem from Robert over in Toronto.
Hi, this is your reporter, Robert Huey, from Toronto, Canada. I have another poem for you. It's called Walking in the Toronto Botanical Garden, one of the smaller botanical gardens in the world, but it's still a great place. Here it is. I turn into the garden, freshened by morning rain, inhale a damp, earthy smell. Photographer with tripod blocks the path to the right. I go left. Discover old chap rooting out last year's rot and freshly sprouted weeds. Usual suspects, dandelions, burdock, stinkgrass. His brow beads heavily with sweat. He grunts as he flicks a dog turd at an unsuspecting pooch, casts an admonishing glance at the owner. I move on. Bees are buzzing, hovering over intoxicating purple spring wonders, crocuses, flowering plants of the iris family. I take the mandatory picture of all things purple for a friend, Mary, not contrary, noting to send later. I shuffle to where a crowd is gathered, watching a painter capture with deft brush strokes what they too will grab with the swift push of a cell phone button. Tai Chi is in full swing too, quiet movements of fluidity. A child points in the direction of the garden cafe, screams bloody blue murder, I want ice cream, chocolate, not Neapolitan. Puts his foot down hard, grinding it in the gravel, kicks a stone into touch, but is ignored by his parents, who search for a particular shade of red rose not yet bloom, or perhaps a way out. I find a quiet place to meditate, let the next lot of garden lovers have the path to themselves, free to observe what I may have missed. Thanks from Toronto. Bye for now.
So that was Robert over in Toronto with his poem. That's the second poem he's been kind enough to send over to us. If you've got a poem you'd like us to show, or perhaps a favourite poem of someone else's that you'd like to recite for us, we'd really appreciate that. That would be, and we like to do things a little bit highbrow here on occasion here at the Fleece Inn. But now we're going to show a piece of footage that I did earlier, down in the bottom of the orchard around the stone circle. Hello and welcome to the stone circle at the bottom of the Fleece Garden, an ancient monument, very much like the Rollwrights or Avebury or even Stonehenge. This ancient monument has been here since 2004, actually, when myself and my friend Chris Hemming and one or two other of my very good friends got together and put this stone circle together. Isn't it an amazing thing? We were trying to wait for sunrise on the 21st of June, which is very, very soon indeed. But unfortunately, the sun didn't rise where we thought it would be. We'd stayed up all night, obviously, keeping ourselves warm with fruit wine and other liquid imbibements. And then we put this in at around dawn on the 21st of June, 2004. Isn't it wonderful? But I love it. And in the middle of it is this lovely tree. And this tree was planted to the memory of Clive Pryke, who we have talked about before, our good friend, artist, and cider drinker extraordinaire. And thus we planted this lovely, lovely tree, which is a Kingston black cider apple tree. So Hopefully we'll get a few apples off it. Not this year, but it's coming. 1 year soon we'll start to get some apples. And just underneath there, just a few Clive's ashes. God bless him. So that is the Fleece Stone Circle and all within. So that was down at the Stone Circle. Good old Clive. Love to have a pint of cider with him now. Do you know what it's time for now? I believe it's time for Julian's Joke.
I recently took a poll and found out that 100% of the people were angry when the tent collapsed.
Thanks, Jules. That's one of a new crop of Julian's Jokes. An absolute phenomenal success as ever, Julian. Thank you. But we're going to finish tonight's show with the lovely Phoebe Appleby. You'll recall that her mum, Sue, was talking about her briefly yesterday, and Sue came and visited us last week and sung a few songs for us outside the barn, and this is the third of those. Hope you enjoy it as much as the other two. But for me, for now, it's good night from Fleece TV.
Funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. Excuse me for getting, but these things I do, see I have forgotten if they're green or they're blue. Anyway, the thing is, what I really mean, and yours are the sweetest eyes I've ever seen. You can tell everybody that this is your song, and maybe quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is now you're in the world. I was a sculptor, but then again, no. Or a god who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. And maybe quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is now you're real.